Now what are you doing?
Now what are you doing?
Oh, you're gonna cry. Yes. Are you tired? Do you need a little nap? Does the pumpkin need a little nap? You've had a pretty big day, haven't you? Have you had a pretty big day?
Parent-child interaction is extremely important to a child's development, particularly in the very early years. Both the quality and quantity of interaction between the parent and child vary tremendously. Some of this variation may be related to the personality of the parent and/or the child. However, variation in the way parents and children interact is also related to the parent's knowledge of positive interactions and their ability and motivation to use those techniques. There is no one right or best way to interact with a child of any specific age. However, there are many very good things which parents can do to enhance their interactions with their children. The mothers and babies in this videotape were filmed on a home videotape series as a part of the Mothers of Newborns Home Visitation Project, a research project sponsored by the Iowa STAT team. We'll view mothers interacting with their infants, who are approximately 2 months old. We've selected 8 behaviors, all of which characterize positive interactions with babies of this age. These are excellent examples of the particular behaviors, although the technical quality of the tape is not always so good. While this is certainly not an exhaustive list of positive parental behaviors for this age group, it is a somewhat inclusive list. These behaviors include physical contact, holding the baby, playing with the baby, looking at the baby, smiling at the baby, saying the baby's name, and using social and referential speech with the baby. Obviously, each parent will use some of these interactive behaviors more than others. Associated with each of these behaviors is an important variable which we call responsiveness. Responsiveness refers to the parent's actions which are in response to the baby's activity, state, situation, signal, or vocalization. Behavior which is responsive is very appropriate and positive. This does not mean that a parent should not initiate behavior, but rather that such initiation takes into account the child's readiness at that particular moment. The interactions which we'll see show how responsiveness is manifested in the 8 interactive behaviors. Almost all the segments selected to illustrate these behaviors also illustrate other behaviors, even though we will focus on only one behavior in each illustrative segment. The first mothers illustrate physical contact. Physical contact includes hugging, kissing, caressing, fondling, ruffling the baby's hair, and cuddling. It may also include deliberate, active physical stimulation, rocking, bouncing, tickling, and physical games such as pat-a-cake or roughhousing with the baby. It involves the mother touching the baby. These mothers show variations of physical contact from the deliberate stimulation of the first mother to the soft touching in the last segment.
We can change your shirt. Yeah. Say, oh boy, I could take my clothes off. Say, oh boy. Oh boy. no. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, there we are. There we are. Boo. Boo. Beep, 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 beep.
She's trying to find her shirt.
Yeah. Hey. Mom's got you. Mom's got you. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Oh boy, now we're talking.
You feel better? Feel better?
Good.
Give me your fingers. Give me your fingers. Hold on our hands. Hold our hands together.
In the next segment, the mothers illustrate holding the baby. Babies need a lot of holding, and parents don't need to worry about doing it too much. The first mother is holding her baby while playing, and the other is holding her baby to feed her.
What do you think? Oh. That'll make you smile, doesn't it? I can really wait to make you smile. Yes. Up, sit up like a big boy. Sit up like a big boy. Oh, don't make it fuzzy. Don't make it fuzzy. Watch out.
But they're getting so red because they're so tired. They're getting so red. Oh. Ready for some more?
Next, we see the mothers actively playing with the child. Although the first mother uses the commercial toy, she could also use her fingers, as the second mother does, or a book, or other material, or even play a game with the child.
Yeah. You need some pretzels, don't you? You don't have any pretzels. Here it is. Yeah, you got no pretzels. There it is. It's back. Oh, yeah. To exercise that double chin. Yes, you do. Up and back. I took it too fast. Here it is. It's on Junie's tummy. It's on her foot. It's on her foot. Yeah. Kick, kick, kick. Kick, kick, kick. Yeah, hear that? That makes more noise, doesn't it? Kick, kick, kick. Kick it, Julie. Can we see? Let's do this one. Can we see if you can follow Mom's hand? Huh? Can you follow Mom's hand? That's a good girl. Where's it going? Where's it going? Where's it going? Stephanie. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? It went and hid, didn't it? See, yeah, Mom, it went and hid.
The next mother is a good example of looking at the infant. She focuses on the baby's face for some time, longer than a glance. Babies like faces and will engage in mutual looking for several seconds.
Such a big yarn.
Yes.
Yes. Are you hungry?
Are you hungry?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, stretch.
Yes.
Oh, goodness. Are you ready to eat?
Now we'll watch a simple behavior, a smile, which is often overlooked. The mother smiles and laughs at the baby and shows other positive, nonverbal expressions.
There. There. Hi. Oh, boy. You laughed.
In the next segment, note the mother's use of the baby's name, both alone or in a sentence.
Aren't you glad that you have a girl to be a friend to? I think you should be. I think you can grow a little bit, Paul, in this thing. You got lots of room here. Okay, you're all done.
Yes, my eyes get so big. They get so big.
Oh, I kind of bounce you around a little bit, don't I?
I got a bit. Oh, you're going to give a smile.
We'll give a little smile. See? We'll just boop, 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 boop. You like him? See his smile?
He's smiling at you.
Yeah.
He's smiling at you, Paul.
Can you see? Can you look over here? Look over here. Oh.
My eyes get so big.
You want to see what other toy we got here? Oh, look at this. Looks like pretzels.
You know what a pretzel is? You want to take that in your hand?
Mm-hmm. You could put it on like a bracelet, couldn't you?
Oh, that kind of makes me blink.
Let's put that in your hand. See if you'd take it. I don't think you will very long, will you? I'm going to drop it, I bet. I got it for a little bit. No. I just don't feel like playing with it right now, do I?
Oh.
Now let's focus on social speech. Social speech includes singing, whistling, whispering, verbal games such as peekaboo, verbally soothing the baby, or using single responsive words such as oops or oh, or short responsive questions such as what do you want or what's the matter. It also includes praise and verbal expressions of positive feelings. We'll watch several mothers engaged in social speech with their babies. Note the responsiveness of both the mothers and babies in these segments.
Hi, sweetie.
How are you today?
Huh? Well, how are you doing today? Are you doing pretty good or not so good?
Hmm?
Yeah. Okay, that's pretty good. Can you tell Mom about it? Huh? Can you tell me about it? Well, let me hear about it. Sure, I'd be glad to hear about it. But there's no way I can know anything if you don't tell me the story. Huh? Can you tell me the story? Huh? Can you tell me a story? I'd love to hear one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, then what did he say? After he said that, then what did he say? Oh, really? Is that what he said? Well, then what did you say back to him? Hmm? Did you say something back to him? Did you? Probably not, Mom. Probably not. I didn't have anything else to say. Did you have anything to say? Huh? Well, then what did you say? Oh, I see. Well, then, I'll bet that shut him up, didn't it? Huh? I'll bet that just shut him up, huh? Yeah, I bet it did. Oops, here we go. Oh, yes, here we go. Let's pull our shirt down. Look like a big girl. Oh, well, I'll be darned. That must have made you pretty upset when he said that, didn't it? So what'd you say then? Oh, you're going to have to learn not to interrupt Mom when she's asking you a question. Uh-huh. Oh, well, if that's the way you feel about it, okay, that's fine. Can you tell me another story? Oh, okay. Oh, come see Mom. Come and see what a sweet baby you are.
Did you have a good sleep, Jeff?
Did you have a good sleep? It's kind of hard to wake up, isn't it? You're sleeping so sound. Oh, that's you. Bless you. Does that make you laugh when you do that?
Huh?
Does that make you laugh? Let's get this away, okay?
Finger. Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me about it. Yeah. Uh-huh. Is that what happened, really? Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay.
Finally, referential speech is different from social speech in that the mother refers to the environment, labeling it, giving the baby information about objects, toys, people, or other things. Notice how this mother describes the toy to her baby.
This. You see what she bought you? You see that? Is that a good thing to look at?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's interesting, isn't it? It's kind of like the one that hangs in your bed. Is that nice? You see? It's pretty, isn't it? It makes a lot of nice noises. Lots of colors. Think of those circles in your bed? Huh? Okay. Oh, would you like to hold that? Hold it in your neck. Yeah, that's a nice smile.
Oh.
That's a nice one. Yeah. I guess playing wasn't such a bad idea. Was it? Would you like to hold it? Huh? Way up in the air, way up in the air. It comes down, it goes down cold. Whoosh, it's gotcha. Whoosh, that's funny, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah. What up here? Way up like in the bed. And it's gonna come down. It's gonna come down. Ooh.
So we see there are many ways to interact positively with infants. While there is no recipe for positive interaction, there is an observable difference between good and poor interaction. In poor interaction, there would be an absence of the positive types of behaviors we've illustrated here. It's always a matter of degree in both quality and quantity. Additionally, poor interaction might include not only less of the positive interactions shown here, but also negative interactions, such as negative vocalizations to the baby. Intent is also important. The same words spoken either for fun or for scolding, can have tremendously different meanings for the child. We've seen examples using mothers, but obviously this material applies to fathers also. We hope both fathers and mothers will take advantage of this information to enhance their parenting skills. Fathers, mothers, and other caretakers can enhance both the quality and quantity of interaction with children. Interaction needs to be responsive, varied, and individual. Interaction is the key to the child's total development.
Echo.
Huh? Can you tell me that one again?
Ow.
Well, I'll be darned. Is that what happened? Really? Well, then what happened? Huh? Then what happened? Okay, then you said that. Then what did he say? Huh? Well, were you talking to her, he or she? Oh, I see. Well, did you tell him you were tired and you wanted to take a nap and you couldn't come out and play?